So with American Horror Story Apocalypse reaching the second half of its season, I am left to wonder whether or not Michael Langdon should actually win at the end of the day. So let's talk about it. Hey YouTubers, don't forget to subscribe and hit that bell over by the subscriber button to notify you every single time I upload. Enjoy the video. That's right guys, American Horror Story Apocalypse and whether or not Michael should actually win at the end of this season. So I know for a fact this show likes to have its kind of happy, if not a little bit ambiguous endings from time to time. And I think I know a perfect way for them to do that where it's kind of allowing it to happen both ways. But, you know, based off of not only the title, but also as a lot of people have been commenting in the comment section, this whole season has gotten off track. I think a lot of people, myself included, like the flashback episodes for what they're worth. They're fun. I love the connection between Coven and Murder House, and knowing that we're going to get Jessica Lange back is just all the better for it. But I agree, we've kind of lost sight as to where this show was going in its first three episodes. The concept that there is an apocalypse happening and that the human race can or cannot be saved. Witches versus the Antichrist, that is interesting to me. Of course, you got to set up the pieces. The very fact, though, that they're doing it through flashbacks instead of starting with it. Maybe you had to start with a big bang. I understand that, and the apocalypse is a huge bang to start off with. But maybe there would have been a better way to integrate the flashbacks, kind of like what they did in Murder House, as it plays out as the story of Apocalypse is playing out in front of us. I've already speculated, and I guess I should just drop this here because I don't think it really deserves its own video, that this week's episode is going to be actually longer than other previous episodes, an extra long one with Jessica Lange. Pretty awesome. An hour and a half runtime, so about 55 minutes versus the normal 40, 42 minutes. So more Jessica Lange kind of puts a wrench in my thought that we're going to get two Murder House episodes. Maybe we're only going to get one and just go directly back to the main story after knowing how Michael connects with Constance and Miss Mead and everyone else. How did he get to the Warlocks, right? Anyway, I think once we get back to the apocalypse story, whether it's all going to take place in the bunker or whether they're going to actually go out and fight in the open or find other bunkers or go to this place that he was talking about to begin with or whatever, it's going to be witches versus Michael. And even though they've gone a long way in the last couple episodes to show the witches have a few cards up their sleeve, not only with Cordelia being the supreme and a bunch of the other witches being brought back to life, but also Mallory, as a lot of people have speculated on, either a fairy, which I don't really agree with, or an angel, which I think is an interesting concept, there to fight him, then they're going to win, right? That's just the idea that a lot of people have, is he is going to be bested, the human race is going to be brought back, Emily, Timothy, the Adam and Eve characters for this show being brought back in such a way to show that the human race is going to survive, it's just going to start over, and that's what the whole apocalyptic situation is actually about. It's like, you know, birth, death, and rebirth, right? So we've done this. We've played this game so many times in this show before where we don't really have a horrifying, what are we going to do now ending. And if there was ever a time to actually do that, I think it would probably be this season. Michael's a character that we've known or at least had some inclination about since the first season of American Horror Story. And I think that they need to bring him back and bring him back with a bang. Allow him to actually win the day and then walk away the victor. Human race is completely dead. Not completely. I mean, there's still some zombie-like people out there and some roamers with tumors, all this other stuff. But he wins. Horrifying ending. Last hope vanquished. And then we just kind of walk away with it, right? To me, that's kind of an interesting ending. Of course, they're not going to do that. If you wanted to know how I think they're going to do it, Mallory's going to bring back people who died in the third episode. Timothy and Emily, Adam and Eve characters, and then Michael is going to continue living on, having been bested, but in kind of a serpent form, and they're just going to do the whole Adam and Eve story yet again. You know, evil will always persist as long as good is out there, and vice versa. So I think that's how they're going to end it. But if you ask me, and I want to hear y'all's thoughts and opinions, it's time for Michael to win. It's time to have a horrific, oh my gosh, how is this going to pan out ending for American Horror Story, right? Especially if season 9 is going to be somehow tangibly connected to season 8, and then season 10, as I've already speculated, could be, let's go back way in the past and figure out how all this is connected because we're going back to where it all began type of season, and that's just how they end the show. But What are your thoughts here, guys? Do you like the idea of Michael winning, or do you like the idea of Mallory and the witches winning? Tell me in the comment section below. Don't forget to like and subscribe. Hit that bell over by the subscriber button to notify you every single time I upload. It's been real.